This is a 12-episode anime, right?
I was going to go easy on
right? Am I right? Because by how this episode ended, it's left me wondering that this anime is only like an OVA, a 4-episode OVA. Really? Everybody's dying. It's only episode 2. How? Honestly, man, I do not know how they're going to get away from this. I do not know how they're going to survive this. I really don't know, man. We've seen like 20 people die already. There's 100 left. If that's just insane, man. That everyone's fucking dying, and I don't know how they're gonna get out of this. Second thing is the censoring. Oh god, the censoring, guys. Oh. I've never nitpicked censoring, you know, in any anime. Yeah, I always said, okay, I don't like the censoring. It sucks. Blah blah blah. But this, it took the cake, man. They censored the whole screen. There was parts that they censored the whole fucking screen, except for their legs. We could only see their feet moving. What the? The censoring sucks, man. It sucks. There's nothing we could do about it. I guess that's the law, man. That's what I'm thinking. Cause they aired this in Japan, and they're pretty strict with their laws over there. So they got a censor. You know, they got no choice. Cause they aired it on cable. Meanwhile, we stream it on the internet, so that's why we don't really like the censoring, but over there, they gotta do what they gotta do. But overall, man, the censoring fucking sucks, Well, we gotta deal with it, man. We just gotta deal with it and, you know, move on with our lives. But, you know, as far as the censoring goes, the animation, the music, oh, don't even get started with the music, the opening. Definitely one of the best of the fall season, even though there's no other openings, you know, that to be heard, but this is definitely a good opening. I love the visuals, the music, catchy song, you know, fast paced. I like the fast paced songs, and definitely gonna be one of my favorites for this fall season. The ending, oh, no, the roaches invaded the ship. They're not even in Mars yet, and they're getting destroyed already. So what does that tell you? Carnage, that's what it's telling you. People are dying, man. I'm telling you, right now, a lot of people are already dead. We already get one of the main characters, which I thought would be a main character. I don't know if he's considered main. But the guy who got mad was about to punch the other guy in the face before I even got in the way. He's already dead. Yeah, because at first I thought it was going to take this route. You know how they typically do it, you know. Somebody gets in a fight. Those two become a main, you know, part of the main plot. We get in little snippets, little clips of other people that will play a big role in the anime. We got that. What I didn't get was some of those guys are already dead. So, what? Really, this is Attack on Titan kind of like brutality. Like, you do not know who will die. Everyone is a target. Everybody has a death flag. Nobody is safe in this anime. Yeah, if you like that kind of anime, check this out. I like that kind of anime. It leaves me wondering. It gets me surprised. I was really surprised when he died. But the thing is, they invaded. And that's what I like about this anime, too. They're comparing roaches to humans, and you know the similarities, it's quite shocking. They go into detail how cockroaches, you know, they get into any place they want. They always sneak in. That's what exactly what they're doing right now. Even though they're fucking, you know, Hulk cockroaches, they found a way to sneak in the ship. That's insane. What I'm thinking is, so that leaves you wondering, how did they get in the ship when they're freaking 20 feet tall, muscular? How is that possible? The only explanation I could think of is they got in when they were little, and I guess since they were getting closer to Mars, some of the radiation might have got there, and then they transformed in the ship. That's what I'm thinking, or somebody intentionally made these cockroaches the way they are. So there might be a little backstabber in the ship, a little antagonist in the ship right now that's causing all this. So one of those two things. But the thing is, you know, with both Marcus and Ivan, I think those were their guys' names, they ran off because they were trying to pee in the shower. they snuck off. They're trying to find the medicine to, you know, fight back with these roaches. But the thing is, the roaches found it first, so these roaches actually have intelligence. You know, they went straight for the medicine, so they got no way to fight back. That's what I'm thinking. How in the hell are they gonna get out of this? It's almost impossible unless we get to see some, you know, Kogami, Michelle kind of team up. I don't know. I think Kogami still has it in him. I don't think he needs the medicine anymore. I think he could do it by himself. But he announces the mission has failed, so that just leaves me like, what? But we see in the beginning, in the very first scene of the anime, we get to see that we get a little meeting of the main honchos. So I'm guessing these guys are like the top of the top you know, best of the best. There's like 5 of them or 10 of them, I forgot. But they were talking about how this virus, you know, it spread. It spread pretty quickly in the past 20 years. It was introduced to the Earth 47 years ago. And that's what they're going to Mars to get a little bit of samples, some resources to help them counteract the virus. We also get a little bit of shipping. Shayla sort of has a thing for the captain. Vice versa, it's not gonna happen. I could just tell. Ivan is a fool of love, and these are the characters I love the most because they're foolishly likable. He falls in love with Shayla, like love at first sight kind of thing, and yeah, that's pretty funny, I guess. But honestly, man, I'm not gonna try getting attached to these characters. I feel like Shayla's gonna die a horrible death. Ivan, he's foolish people always die. He's gonna die too. The only people I see actually like surviving like a long time is Michelle, Gogami, Shella, I think that's her name, Shella, and the main people that were in a meeting. Those are the only people I actually see surviving, and our main character, Gotti. Other than that, man, everyone else is gonna probably be fodder to the roaches. Ivan, man, I love that guy. I love Ivan. You know, he's a fool. We're all fools, baby. But we see a little bit of fights break out during the whole trip to Mars. It just, this is what I thought was going to happen. I told you, they're going to fight, and this whole fight's going to be like a little plot device to get us introduced to these characters. To know, okay, these guys are going to play a big role, but some of them died already, so I'm not going to really go into detail with that. But, you know, a little fight broke out. Ivan got punched in the face by accident. Everyone's getting restless. That's pretty much the whole thing. The thing I like, though, is you know, Shayla's group. They're the only group that's actually, you know, in touch with each other. They actually enjoy each other's company. And that's the only group I see that's actually interacting with each other pretty nicely. Everyone else is just, you know, worried about themselves, afraid, picking fights, or just isolating themselves on purpose because they don't like anybody. Like that guy who, with the blonde hair, says, who calls everybody vermin. Yeah, that guy's gonna survive a long time, I could just tell, unless he's the one actually causing the whole roaches. If I have to pick somebody that's actually intentionally making the roaches the way they are, like in the ship, because there's no way they were able to sneak in those roaches, they're fucking too big to do that, it will be that guy right there. I forgot his name, but the one that calls everybody vermin. But we get to see which characters really will stick out through this series and survive and play big roles. We get to see that, we see a lot of these guys. Now, yeah, that's pretty much it, man. The roaches invaded. Yeah, they're massacring everybody. So hopefully, Kogami, Akari, those guys, you know, they fight back. They don't need the power-up. We've seen what they could do. Akari fucking killed a bear. A fucking bear. That says enough of his character. Yeah, man, what do you guys think? Like the video if you guys enjoyed it. Subscribe if you guys want. For more anime stuff. And this is what we got before matter. Peace!